Everyone, if you are listening to this video, then you are in for a treat. What you are about to hear is a section from my podcast that I put out on my Patreon page. So if you enjoy what you hear, then head over to patreon.com/GizEdwards, link in the description box below. Sign up for the $7 tier and enjoy the full 1 hour podcast that I have just posted today. Today, the section you are about to hear is all about, is 6 hours of sleep enough to lucid dream? Thank you very much and enjoy. I understand that when you are sleep deprived, you don't always remember your dreams. And I always think that remembering your dreams is the number one key point of learning how to lucid dream. You have to be able to remember your dreams, and everything stems from that. But the thing that allows you to remember your dreams is your sleeping pattern. And this is why I always ask them, how much sleep do you get and how consistent is that? Because if you were to sleep for 5 hours, that is no time at all. If you were to sleep for 6 hours, you might be okay lucid dreaming, but you might also struggle quite a lot, because the chances of lucid dreaming improve as the night goes on. So the more sleep you get, the greater your chances of lucid dreaming is. And that's not just because you're asleep for longer, that's because of how we sleep and how the brain functions when we sleep. So when we are asleep, our brain goes through a weird state of sleep cycles. It's a fluctuation of brain waves. So it's known as a sleep cycle because it's very predictable. And an average sleep cycle is anywhere between 90 and 110 minutes. But for easy maths, we always associate it with 90 minutes. So we always say a sleep cycle is 90 minutes. It can be lower, it can be 80, and it can be higher than 110 minutes, it can be 120. But on average, 90 to 110 minutes. At the 90 minute mark, we're going to use 90 minutes in this example. We go through a state of awake to sleep, known as stage one of non-REM. We also go through stage two of non-REM and stage three. After we've gone through stage three, we then go back up to stage two. And then we replace stage one with REM, which is our sleep. But the thing is, in our first sleep cycle of the night, our stage of REM is so small. It is so, so small. And one of the reasons it's so small is because our body uses non-REM, so non-dreaming stage of sleep, to excrete growth hormones and start healing the body. In fact, research has shown that anywhere up to 90% of our daily growth hormones are secreted in the first sleep cycle. And not only the first sleep cycle, but the first non-REM section of sleep cycle, which is insane. 90%, up to 90%. However, as the night progresses, so after each sleep cycle, our period of REM gets longer and longer, and it improves. The first sleep cycle, our REM period is about 5 minutes long. Our second sleep cycle is 10 minutes long for REM. Our third sleep cycle is 15 minutes long, and the fourth sleep cycle is 30 minutes long. So four sleep cycles, if we were to take the 90 minutes per sleep cycle rule, will actually only be 6 hours. And it may sound like you have a lot of time to become lucid in 6 hours, but when you break it down, you only get four stages of REM. That's 30 minutes, 15 minutes, 10 minutes, and five. That's 1 hour. And you may think that that's quite a lot to be able to become lucid, but I can assure you that's really not. It's a very small window of opportunity, because not only do we have to get into the period of REM, we also have to experience a bit of the dream to be able to recognize the inconsistencies of the dream world, so that we can question whether or not we're in a lucid dream, or in a dream rather, and then proceed to enjoy the dream. So you won't get that in the first sleep cycle. You won't get that in the second sleep cycle. You might get that in a 15 minute period of REM in the third sleep cycle, and you could get that in the fourth sleep cycle. But where the interesting thing happens is that From your fifth sleep cycle and onwards, your period of REM is anywhere between half an hour and an hour long per sleep cycle. So bearing in mind that your sleep cycle is 90 minutes, an hour of that could be dream time. So if you sleep 6 hours a night, you have potentially an hour of dream time. If you sleep for 7.5 hours sleep, you double that dream time potentially. So you go from 1 hour of dream time over a 6 hour period to 2 hours in a 7.5 hour period. And because the latest sleep cycle is so long in terms of REM, you have plenty of time to be in the dream, explore the dream, recognize that you're in a dream so that you are lucid, and then enjoy the dream world. So that is why I always suggest that people sleep at least 7 to 9 hours. Because if you think about it, you have 7.5 hours sleep, that gives you 2 hours of dream time potentially. But then if you sleep for 9 hours, that gives you 3 hours of dream time potentially. That's a third of your time spent in a dream. By increasing your sleep cycle by either one or two more per night. So, as I said, I always say, how many hours of sleep do you get a night, and whether or not that's consistent? Because consistency is really key when it comes to sleeping. If you wake up at the same time every morning, that's consistency. If you go to sleep at the same time every night, that's consistency. And your body will get into a routine, your circadian rhythm will kick in and appreciate your sleep-wake cycle. This will make it easier to fall asleep, this will make it easier to wake up in the morning, because your body is accustomed to having a very rigid and focused and consistent sleeping pattern. So if you are trying to learn how to lucid dream, not only have we covered that what a lucid dream is and that it's actually just knowing that you're lucid dreaming, but the next thing that you have to do is you have to get consistent sleep. You have to get sleep that is 7, 8, 9 hours per night to have a really good chance of being able to lucid dream. But how do you do that? It's all good me saying that to you, whispering in your ear, but how do you actually get to sleep? How do you adopt a sleeping pattern?